You've heard the question. Who would you give the $100 to? The taxi driver, the police department, or to yourself?
Did you say Phyllis?
Yes, I did.
Oh.
What? Is that the answer?
Ladies and gentlemen, I think we have some kind of a first here.
Well, I know a Japanese restaurant for her.
It was your lousy food, Bert.
Tamara Osborne is a legal secretary who's driven in 5 presidential motorcades. Wow.
Well, I did Clinton 2 different trips. And
one for each.
At Sir Irving's knighting, the queen slipped with her sword, so instead of being knighted, Sir Irving was blanked.
Bar mitzvah.
Name something men wear to bed, Margaret.
A nightcap.
A nightcap, Jeff.
Sweatsuit.
Sweatsuit AW. Yeah.
Nightcap.
Nightcap, Elizabeth.
Condoms.
A condom!
You know, Ben, everybody tries to win your money, but I understand you tried to win Jimmy Kimmel's money by doing something really outrageous on the show.
Well, it seems outrageous now. It didn't seem that outrageous at the time because we'd been drinking a lot of diet soda. But he bet me something that I wouldn't drop trow on TV. He said he would, and would I do it too? And I said, sure, what the heck, I did it. And then the contestant did it too. It wasn't one of my proudest moments, but it wasn't like writing speeches for Richard Nixon, but it was a great moment nonetheless.
And what are my shoes doing there?
Well, your shoes are here because we're playing Strip Ben Stein of his clothes a little earlier. And
this is
all that you managed to get off from Bob. So I was thinking
it's enough.
That if Bob should beat you, perhaps you'd drop your pants.
No, I won't.
Yeah! If you drop your pants, I'll drop mine with you.
I'll think of it.
And you did beautifully. I will briefly drop my pants. Briefly. And Bob, now Jimmy. Don't you think the winner is getting $5,000?
Come on, Bob.
Now let's meet an African explorer.
Number one, what is your name, please?
My name is Peter Agababi Palangian.
Number two.
My name's the same as his.
What do you get when you cross a 70s band with a carload of dwarves? Simple, folks. You get, you're going to like this, the Village Little People!
Young man, there's no place you can go. I said, young man, when you're short on your dough, you can stay there. And I'm sure you will find you will have a good time. It's fun to stay at the YMCA.
We've seen some pretty great stuff so far, but the moments you're about to see will completely blow you away.
We have to introduce another player, and with a great deal of pleasure, we present Karen Lesko. Hi, Karen.
Hi.
You know John?
Yes, we do.
Doesn't she have pretty nipples, pretty dimples there, John? This lady has has very pretty dimples in her cheeks, doesn't she?
Now, the actual number of these wrestlers who could lift Bob Eubanks over their head is 5 of them.
Now, come on, Fiji. No way in heck could you do that, hon.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't. No.
Yeah. You stay away from me, Pete. No. You stay away from me. No.
Welcome to Bullseye. It's a very interesting description Charlie just made there. I play a little golf myself. How's the game these days?
Well, I'm real straight, but not real long.
Well, we all have our problems. I'm real long, but I'm not very straight. How about, well, X gets a square.
You cheated and looked at your card. I saw him looking at your card.
Oh.
He looked back at your card. Get your card.
I knew the answer. This has never happened before in the show. You all saw this? Lisa, could you, maybe our producer would like to come up here and you'd like to talk together.
I'm going
to
go for a Coke. Looking at the card.
Yeah.
No, wait just a minute.
Oh.
I'm leaning back like this and looking at
no,
the card.
Check, please.
I knew the card. I knew the answer.
Next question, ladies. 25-point boner. Bonus question.
You're not going to faint or
anything. Oh, God, no.
All right.
I'm sorry.
If you thought that was wild, you ain't going to believe this.
Name one city outside the United States.
Honolulu.
What do you like if you're a carnivore?
I go to carnivals.
You go to carnivals.
What country fought in the American Civil War?
Spain.
A cowboy likes to show off his holster. What is a holster?
A horse.
What building are you in if you're sitting in the Oval Office?
The Empire State Building?
In the military, you go AWOL?
Uh-huh.
What does that mean?
It's like a promotion.
Who is the host of The Tonight Show with Jay Leno?
Conan O'Brien.
During what months of pregnancy does a woman begin to look pregnant?
September.
Something... First question coming up. Oh, God. Oh, here we go, darling. No, this is coming serious.
In Ben Franklin's kite flying experiment, what object was tied to the string of the kite?
It was the antenna of his house.
What kind of antenna do you think?
I don't know.
His satellite dish was... I said, name a time that most people get up. And being the Einstein that you are, you said, morning.
When I get up.
Our survey said, zip. Now, if that wasn't bad enough, I then said, name a time that most people go to bed. You said, of course, night. Our survey said, two. It's a thing this time. Karen and Steve.
Okay. Strawberry lip girls.
No, that's...
Name an article of clothing that children are always losing.
Their pants.
The price of a dozen roses.
$1.75.
Besides a bird, something in a bird cage.
Hamster.
The popular... Make a note of this joke. Name a famous resort area outside the continental United States.
Tahoe.
Name something people have more than two of on their body.
Eddie.
Arms. More than two arms you've got, have you, Eddie?
Name something people take with them to the beach.
Turkey.
The first thing you buy in a supermarket.
Turkey.
The food often stuffed.
Turkey.
I said to you, name something people take with them to the beach. You said... The answer was... The first thing you buy in a supermarket. The answer was... And the survey gave you... A food often stuffed, you said... And that gave you...
All right, I give up. When we return, we're going to literally put decades of rumors and speculation to rest and show the most talked about clip in game show history. It's nothing I'm very proud of, and it's never been seen on network TV. And it's coming up next.
Okay, you've got to do it. Come on, you've got to do it. You've got to do it.
Let me tell you, all right. We've had a lot of fun during this hour with all of my friends and everything, but I'd like to get serious for just a moment. When they asked me to do this show and they told me they had this clip, my initial instinct was not to do the show. But then I figured out that if I didn't do the show, they were going to show the clip anyway. It's nothing that I'm proud of, and I'm embarrassed. I'm embarrassed for a couple of reasons. Number one, of the thousands of people that I've told that it didn't happen. And number two, I'm embarrassed for the clip itself. The year was 1977. I posed a question to a young couple, and no one expected the answer would become an urban legend. Most say it never happened, and honestly, I didn't think it happened either. But it did happen. And finally, once and for all, here it is. Here's the last of our five-point questions. Girls, tell me where specifically is the weirdest place that you personally, girls, have ever gotten the urge to make whoopee? Olga?
Go ahead.
In the...
No, what I'm talking about is the weirdest location, the weirdest place. Give me an answer, please. He said it was in the car, on the freeway.
Well, that's our show, everyone. We will see you next time. Jim, show us how to do this.
You ready? Here we go, guys.